Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd, also known as 287. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a peaceful and a blessed Sabbath. Now, today's study lesson is entitled, What's in the Heart Comes Out, because ultimately, whatever is in the heart will reveal itself, be it by mouth, your mouth, or their mouth, or by actions. Things have a way of revealing themselves. And also understand this, that when we speak of the heart, we are referring to whatever the truth is in the mind, yours or the other person's, it will all reveal itself. See, we can deceive ourselves sometimes, and we can deceive others by the things we do or say, but eventually we will reveal the truth by our saying or doing, or vice versa, by their saying or doing. What happens is people often reveal this truth, or you yourself reveal this truth, in a less than normal situation. See, be it a tense situation or what have you, this is when these truths will come out, because people have a way of saying or doing what's truly in them under these less than normal or stress situations. So what they do, or what we do sometimes when we reveal ourselves by our action or by our word, we try to cover it up. And we say things like, well, I wasn't aware of what I was doing because I was drunk, for those of you that drink. Or because I wasn't fully awake. I was just coming out of being asleep and you were asking me a question or what have you. Or one of the biggies is because I was mad, frustrated, upset, or what have you. That's the biggie. People like to use their stress as an excuse, and then say they didn't mean what they said or did. And then another one is because of being under the influence of drugs or something like that. It's subjective, but although we may find some of these excuses reasonable or acceptable sometimes, we might want to consider this. Go with me to Matthew 12, 33 through 35, and it reads, it says, either make the tree good and his fruit good, or else make the tree corrupt and his fruit corrupt. For the tree is known by his fruit. O generation of vipers, how can ye, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart the mouth speaketh. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil treasure bringeth forth evil things. So, once again, the word tells us that we are known by our fruit. Now, what is this? Well, the fruit of the Spirit, Galatians 5, 19 through 25, tells us what these characteristics are. We're all known or revealed through this character, either the character of the flesh or the character of the Father. That's how we reveal ourselves, through those things, the fruit, either good fruit or evil fruit. So, of those character traits, we will speak what is. Now, people can lie to anyone with a deceiving tongue during calm and pleasant settings, but if they speak long enough and the situation changes, they'll reveal the truth out of their own mouths about who they truly are and how they truly feel. Now, this is because what is truly in any of our minds or in our heart, as it's expressed in Scripture, is dominant, and it's waiting to come out. It's just waiting for an opportunity to come out, be it good or evil. Eventually, as they say, the truth will come out of your own mouth or out of the other person's mouth, depending on who's doing what in these circumstances. Now, Luke 6, 43 through 45 reads like this. It says, for a good tree bringeth not forth corrupt fruit, neither doth a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. For every tree is known by his own fruit. For of thorns men do not gather figs, nor of bramble bush gather they grapes. A good man out of a good treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is good, and an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is evil. For out of the abundance of the heart the mouth speaketh. Now, we all know people and have been around people who will say, I'm going to say whatever it is I want to say, however I want to say it, whenever I want to say it, and I don't care who hears it or knows it. And they use this mentality as an expression of being liberated and to show that they're not going to be restrained by anyone in any notion that whatever they're going to say or do is wrong. They feel like, I'm me and I'm going to be me. But the word tells us that people who speak like this are a fool. I'm telling you, it says they're a fool. Go with me to Proverbs 29:11. Proverbs 29:11, it reads, it says, a fool uttereth all his mind, but a wise man keepeth it till afterwards. And then Proverbs 12:16 reads that a fool's wrath is presently known, but a prudent man covereth shame. Now, it says a fool's wrath is presently known. There's a reference that says that they let it be known in that day. That's that person that says, I'm going to say whatever I feel, whenever I feel it, how I feel it, right now. And they just shoot their mouth off and just express themselves. See, they have no regard for anything. But the word says that they are a fool. It says a prudent man or a smart person will cover that shame. See, you have to learn how to be still so you don't disgrace yourself. That's all it's saying. So, remember the next time that your heart or your mind reveals itself or someone else reveals himself to you, bypass the excuses that try and explain it away and really consider accepting the reality that you or that individual truly meant what they said. Because, like the word says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. See, we can't make ourselves say or do something that we don't truly mean, can we? And if we do that, then we're just a liar to do that. So my advice is to deal with the truth as you hear it or speak it, or two, keep your lips shut and be still as a prudent man would. And with that, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2 Bait 7. I'm out.